time. The next part, second part of our chapter is moving on pressure. Okay, so we have learned so many forces. Now what are we learning is something is which is related to the force. Okay, I just wanted everyone to just clap your hands like this. Just okay, fine. Now with the same force, take the pen and then poke it in your hand. You yourself poke it. Okay. Yes. Good. Aryan, what do you experience from this both actions? One is clapping or one is this. Which is more painful for you?
The pen.
The pen. The pen is more painful for you. Very good, Aryan. Okay. So, Dia, now,
yes,
which has got more area? Is this is big or the poking the pen? A particular place is big for us.
Clap.
Clap is, yeah. Clap is a big area and this is less area. And then, did you use the same force while you poke and while you clap? Did you use the same force? No, you use different force. Correct. Okay. For which action, Avinita, you used more force? Is it for clapping used or for poking you used?
For clapping.
Clapping you use that much? Or poking like this?
Ma'am, for poking.
For poking.
Yeah, little bit more is poking. Correct? So we cannot clapping, we can just do like this. Poking you must have done like this. Correct? So that means there is a more force but less area. Now both of them connecting, we are getting the new thing, that is pressure. So what is the pressure? Now connecting pressure, everyone, you can write the heading pressure. So now you come to the point, pressure is the force acting per unit area. That is for one unit area, one area. One area means 1 cm². You must have used centimeter square in max, correct? Centimeter square or meter square in max. Okay, so 1 cm² or 1 m². 1 unit means it is actually is equal to 1 m², not the centimeter. Okay, so 1 m², how much force you apply, that is known as pressure. So pressure is the force acting per unit area. Now you are learning the one equation. How can you find out the pressure? You can find the pressure by dividing the value of force, we call it value, or we can also call magnitude. Instead of value, in physics, we use a word magnitude. Magnitude or value. So, if you divide the value or magnitude of force with the magnitude of area, then we can calculate pressure. So pressure is equal to force divided by area. P stands for pressure, F stands for force, A stands for area. So physics, we don't every time, you don't write entire equations every time. First, after learning, the next step, use the symbols. Use the symbols means alphabets. It can be alphabets. So here, P stands for pressure, F stands for force, A stands for area.
Area.
Yeah. Okay. Agash Krishnan, what is the unit of force, Agash? SI unit of force. SI unit of force, what do we call, Agash? Some scientist name. You remember that? SI unit
of
force.
Ma'am, can I?
Newton.
Yes. Priyana, what is that?
Newton.
Newton. How do we represent with which letter the Newton?
N.
Similarly, SI unit of pressure is Pascal. This is another scientist. Pascal, or we can represent capital PA, or another unit, what we get, Newton per meter square. So Pascal also known as Newton per meter square. So SI unit of pressure is Pascal, PA, or you can also write Newton per meter square. So below that you can write 1 Newton meter square is equal to 1 Pascal. 20 Newton per meter square is equal to how many Pascals? 1 Newton per meter square is equal to 1 Pascal. Therefore, 20 Newton per meter square is equal to how many Pascal?
20
Pascal. Correct? Because 1 is equal to 1. Similarly, 6 Pascal is equal to how many Newton per meter square?
6
Newton per meter square. Why do you say 6 Newton per meter square? That we are getting from this equation. Because we already know the SI unit of force is Newton. Area in max we use as what? In area of the rectangle in max, what we use? Length into breadth is equal to, suppose?
Length into breadth is equal to.
How do you say? Centimeter square. There it is centimeter square, but in physics, all the units are in meter. Okay. So, Newton per, this Newton divided by meter square. That is what we write, Newton per meter square. Or, we can also write like this, Newton meter raised to minus 1. This way also you can write. Okay. Sorry, so not minus 1, minus 2, because we have 2 here. So I think you have not studied the indices and integers of our exponents. Did you start exponents in your max?
Yes, ma'am.
You have started already exponents?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then you will be understanding, no, how this 2 become negative. Did you learn that? What is exponents? Okay, let me ask you, 10 square into 10 square. What is the answer is going to be? Exponents you have learned. You told you have learned it. Which teacher teach you? Deepa ma'am only, no?
Vinita ma'am.
Vinita ma'am.
Oh, for you, Vinita ma'am. So Vinita ma'am already started exponents?
No ma'am, last year.
Last year. Can you tell me 10 square into 10 square, what is your answer is going to be? A raised to m into a raised to n is equal to? Have you learned this? A raised to m into a raised to a. A raised to m plus n. A raised to. A raised to m divided by a raised to
m minus n.
A raised to m minus n. Okay. Similarly, 1 by a raised to m. How do you write this? 1 divided by a raised to m. How can you write that? A raised to m by a raised to n, you wrote a raised to m minus n.
A raised to m minus 1.
A raised to m minus 1. Correct? Okay? Yes, this is the same thing I have written here. M raised to minus 2. You got it now? So, yes, physics, physics requires some mathematics basics. Especially, decimal, addition, subtraction, division, all that. Indices, integers, addition, all the operation, addition, then fractions, 3 by 5 into 4 by 3, 3 by 5 plus 4 by 3. So all this we require if you want to study physics a little bit. Why? In physics, majority all the theories are, we are proved with the help of problems. Okay, you will be understanding when we do the problem. So 1 by a raised to m, you wrote a raised to m minus 1. That's the same thing I have done. Newton divided by meter square, I wrote it. Newton m minus 2. Got it? So this is, we will be using while you do the problem. Okay, now we are moving on to next. What are the factors affecting pressure? That means, how can you say a pressure increasing and decreasing? That's what we are going to see. So you can write the heading, factors affecting pressure. explain factors affecting pressure, explain. Okay, so suppose this is a descriptive question, you need to write factors affecting pressure, explain. So mainly I asked Dia and other girls also, I asked, did you apply the same force? So you told me no. The second activity I used more force. Then I asked about area, is it which area is greater? So you told me the first activity the area is greater, but second activity we use less area. But which activity give you more pain? Which activity gave you more pain?
Second activity.
What was the reason for it? First factor, the force you applied was greater. That's the first factor. Second factor, area was less.
Area smaller.
So these are known as factors. So from this, what you understand? If force increases, pressure increases. If area decreases, that means if area is small, pressure will be greater. So these are so many examples in our daily life. Okay, you must have seen if two girls are moving. Okay, I just think about Amy, Afrin Amy, and Avanita was walking on the sand. Maybe Amy was wearing a high heel shoes and Avanita was using a usual sandal with a flat surface. I am asking you, whose feet will be sink into the sand? Is it Amy's or Avanita's?
Amy's.
Amy's. Amy, you got that point? You wore high heel. So your feet went inside the sand, but Avanita wore flat. But her legs did not move for that much, did not sink that much. This is the same reason. What is the reason? Amy was a high heel shoe, so what is the area? Is it greater or small for Amy's shoes?
Smaller.
Area smaller. So while she stamped on the sand, more pressure acted. So that's why her feet went inside. While Avanita has a flat sandal, area is more. So the pressure exerted by her body was less. So she exerted force on the sand and Amy also exerted the force on it. But the effect was different. The reason is that Amy was using a small area full all her weight. Avanita was using large area with all her weight. So that is the reason between the pressure exerted by the sand. Got it? So that is the second factor. Okay, so shall we now write explain? Explain means first you will write the factor. First one, force applied. So what you will write? Greater the force applied. So this is the explanation. Greater the force applied on an object. So these are some of the points in the point of your MCQ. Next MCQ, I can ask you, greater the force applied on an object, then dash is the pressure. Option will be greater, smaller, less, or minimum. So you have to choose which is minimum. Okay. So greater the force applied on an object, less the pressure. Less the pressure or smaller the pressure, both phase you can frame. Less the pressure or smaller the pressure. Or vice versa. What do you mean by this vice versa?
Or the other way.
Just opposite, correct? So less, smaller the force applied. Sorry. Here there's a mistake. Force applied, no? Sorry. Greater the force of an object, greater the pressure. The same. Both are same. Sorry. In this case, both are same. Greater the force applied on object, greater the pressure, or vice versa. Vice versa means smaller the force applied, smaller the pressure. So that is first factor. Second factor, area. Can write? Smaller the area of an object, object, greater the pressure. So here it's just opposite. First one is both are same, but here it is just opposite. Smaller the area of an object, greater the pressure, or vice versa. You know what do you mean by vice versa?
Opposite.
Opposite. That is greater the area, smaller the pressure. So these are important points you need to understand. Okay. Can you just I can just ask some of them, those I did not ask so far. Dennis, can you just give me any life example for where you experience less pressure or more pressure in our life?
If there are a lot of nails, iron nails, if you lay on them, there will be no damage done. If
yes,
we lay
good.
On one nail, we will get a severe wound.
Yeah, yes, it's really exactly big circus people do know this kind of tactics. So you will be wondering, oh God, they will get pain like that. It's not like that. When there are more nails, usually the pressure exerting from the body on the nails are less, more than one nail. Okay, similarly, same thing I can talk about. If you wanted to fix a photo on the wall, we should use sharper nail or blunt nail?
Sharper
nail. Okay, because why? When you hammer it, sharper nail will exert more pressure and it will get inside the wall. If you use blunt nail, it won't get inside. Got it that? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is about pressure. Pressure is the force acting per unit area. So shall we now go to the another point? So from this, what you understand? There's a lot of thing to do with the force and pressure. Okay. That means one. So this is the pressure and force. How pressure and force relation is actually. Pressure and force relation. First point, pressure describes how a force is spread over an area. When you apply an unbalanced force, you have learned unbalanced and balanced force. If you apply an unbalanced force, the power of that force depend upon how much it is spread. So pressure is describes how a force is spread over an area. And also from this, what you understand, pressure is a measure of how much force is acting on certain area. It also will tell you how much force acting on a particular area. So from this, therefore, pressure is equal to force per unit area. Can you tell me what is equal to force from this equation? Pressure is equal to force divided by area. Then from this equation, how can you calculate the force from the same equation? Joel, pressure is equal to force divided by area. Therefore, F is equal to, if you want
into
to calculate, what is that?
Multiplication.
P into A. So you understood. So if you multiply pressure into A, you will able to find out the force. Okay, over.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So shall we do one problem using this equation? So let us now write first problem. Calculate the pressure acting on a nail of area 2 cm². Calculate the pressure acting on a nail of area 2 cm² with the force of 20 newton. calculate the pressure acting on a nail at 2 cm square with a force of 20 newton. So before you doing that, you know Max, you have studied, but still I want you to learn this relation. 1 cm is equal to 10⁻²⁻ m. 1 cm² is equal to 10⁻⁴ m. So learn this to do the problem. Similarly, 1 m is equal to 100 cm. So write this because we need to do this. 10⁻⁴ m². Sorry, 1 cm. You will be understanding this when the your teacher will teach you about regarding these conversions. Now at present you are only learn this for the physics because physics is a little bit ahead. So 1 cm is equal to 10⁻²⁻ m. 1 cm² is equal to 10⁻⁴ m² and 1 m is equal to 100 cm. Okay, very good. Now. Advaith, can we do the problem now? Yes, our sir. Question is to what is that? What you have to find out from this problem? By read the question, what you understand? Calculate.
Calculate the pressure acting on a nail of 2 cm² with force of 20 newton.
Okay, what is the equation for pressure? We have just now learned. Yes, so we can do it. Pressure is equal to force bar area. What is the force, Alan? What is the force is given here? What do you identify from these two values? Which is force, which is area?
Ma'am, force is 200 newton.
Twenty newton and
area. And area is 2 cm².
But you cannot write 2 over there. Why? Because we have know that SI unit of pressure is newton per meter square. So we need to convert it meters take this 2 cm² into meter square. So for that only I have given you this. 1 cm² is 10⁻⁴ m². So Dennis, then what will be this 2 cm², Dennis?
1 minute.
Don't multiply. Okay, you just tell me how you do. 1 cm² is 10⁻⁴. Then what will be 2 cm². What we should do in order to convert it into meter square? Only that you tell me. 1 cm² is 10⁻⁴ m². Then 2 cm², how do you write that? Dion, any idea?
20.
So 20 into 2 into 10⁴. Correct. 20 by 2 into 10⁻⁴. Did you understand that? Why I did that? Because here the unit is centimeter. We wanted pressure in meter square. So what we have to do? You have to use this relation. What is this relation? 1 cm² is equal to 10⁻⁴ m². But 2 means 2 into 10⁻⁴. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Now what you do, let it keep it 10⁻⁴ just like that. Just keep it like that. You only do this part. That's enough. Now you do 30 by 2. What do you get?
10.
So you will get 10 by 10⁻⁴ pascal. Because 10⁻⁴ is down. Now you told me. A by, did I teach you a⁴ by a⁴? This is that way. 10 means 10⁻⁴. So if I take it up, what is going to be? 10⁻⁴ going to be up. then what it is going to be?
10 raised to plus 4.
10 raised to, yes, very good. Minus 4 become plus 4. Minus 4 become plus 4 when you take it up. So naturally you are going to get 10 raised to 5 pascal. So this is why I taught you. You need to study this. Okay. You take it 10 raised to minus 4 upstairs. Already 110 is there. So 10 raised to 1. Here also 10 raised to plus 4 it become. Add both of them. Just like max. You do it. Then you will get the answer 10 raised to 5 pascal. So for that you need to by heart this relation. Okay.
None.
Any doubt regarding this?
No, ma'am.
Only you study this. Study that indices equation. Then you will able to this thing here. Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I have a doubt.
Tell me.
Ma'am, where does the other 10 go?
Which 10, my dear?
Ma'am, the 10. 10 raised to 1 by 10 raised to minus
10. If by 10 raised to 1, this 10 raised to 1 already there. Okay.
Yes,
then 10 raised to minus 4, I took it up. Then what it become?
Plus 4.
Plus 4. So what I did, I put together because both are same only. 10 only, no. A is same, correct? So?
Yes, ma'am.
With that 10 raised to 1, we added that 10 raised to 4. That's how we got the answer.
Got okay, it? Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, students. So don't miss the class again, dear. Because physics, you need to understand a lot. Okay? Okay. Thank you, children.
Thank you,
ma'am.
One problem I did, but you need to practice it. Okay? Thank you, dear.